And I'm so excited to have today's star because she's come from so far and we've loved her for so long. And we're like, when is she coming back home? Wendy Kimani just walks into the studio. Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you guys doing?
We're good. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Welcome back. And like, yeah. I was like, yeah, she's coming. And Shafi was like, so I should come with the child and the husband.
Yeah, I just need to confirm.
You want to have no show. That's what
No, we know how to control kiss kids.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Hey, maybe you, not me.
Yeah. I'd be here as Adele is conducting the interview. I'd be here just like, you know, taking care of the baby.
Yeah.
Yes.
Shafi, you.
Hey.
You know, Kids FM.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, Kids FM. Yeah, in the mean, you know, that's what I do, man.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. You
never leave the baby behind, man.
You know what?
The baby is a celebrity.
Yeah.
Yes.
Next time, man.
No, but so we've been following you online. Thank God for the internet, because even though you're like so far away, we can still like, you know, catch up with you and everything that's going on your end.
Yeah.
Online with, you know, first and foremost your hair and giving people tips on that.
Yeah.
But the most recent thing that even made news here was when you shared your birth story, and it was like the
I could
not even, like, I see a picture, I was like, nope. Can't do this.
Adele, you can do it. No, but seriously, that was something. Even when I was being taught hypnobirthing, I was like, this was Mzungu stuff, you know.
So what is that?
I was like, how am I gonna do this?
What exactly is that?
It's basically hypnotizing yourself to the point where you can manage the pain.
Okay.
Like, the pain is manageable.
Okay, so you get hypnotized and then you manage the pain, meaning you don't use, you don't get induced.
No, inducing is different. It's making you...
Oh, no, I'm saying that, like, you don't get any of the...
No meds.
At all.
And when you say, I'm going to be such an African, when you say hypnotizing, is it like the way we see in the movies?
Like, is it like hypnosis?
Is it like hypnosis?
It's putting yourself in hypnosis. Seriously, you're in a bubble of yourself. So you start breathing, because you know you labor almost 24 or 36 hours.
Yes, depending.
So
you know.
Mm-hmm. So from the beginning,
Adele doesn't know.
Yeah,
does. Adele has no idea.
You don't know.
You guys are like,
You definitely know. Yes.
Wait, so you
really like, you breathe from the beginning and you're breathing in and out. It's a wave. 1 minute contraction, rest. 1 minute contraction, rest for however long it takes.
Yeah.
By the time you're getting too close giving birth, you are in a bubble.
By the time the baby's popping.
Yeah. You're literally like in a zen situation.
Okay, hold up. So where are you doing all this, first of all?
At home.
Just at home?
Yeah, at home.
So you didn't go to Hosi?
My living room.
You didn't go to Hosi?
Eh, midwives.
Nothing.
Everything there.
No dokis,
my
nothing.
Mom was freaking out. I was like, this Wendy, why are you doing this hippie stuff all the time?
Uh-huh.
All the time. I was, but yeah, at home.
And it worked. But I think it's a state of mind. I think it's a state of mind.
Of course, pain is there. Yeah. But you can manage.
Manageable pain.
You can manage it.
I don't think there's anything.
Funny how did
like
people used to do it?
Yeah,
epidural came the other day.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
People before did it.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Like, call me Adele when it's time.
When you say hypnosis in Kenya, it's that borderline magic.
Yes, witchcraft.
That's witchcraft.
You do this, like, no. And my doula is actually from Costa. I'm actually giving me. No, I'm kidding. She's from Costa. She's an amazing woman, Naomi. And she's the one who actually taught me everything I know.
So she came there, or she's based there?
No, she lives there.
But she's from Mombasa.
Hold up. So this, you say this Mzungu thing. Kumbe it's a Mombasa Madhe who came to do this thing.
But you know when you see these things, you always say this Mzungu, this white people stuff, you know? You know what I mean?
Oh my
but
God.
That's dope, because you know what? Giving birth in a hospital is damn expensive. That
and
I can tell you for free.
And they hurry you up.
Yeah, because of the other.
There's
time.
Yes, because they manage to
room. Someone's bed.
Someone else has to come in.
Yeah.
So you Adele, I'm thinking now you should consider that.
Nope.
Hypnosis.
It's called what? Hypnobirthing.
Hypnobirthing.
You'll be a professional auntie.
That's what I'm about.
You'll be everybody's auntie.
Yeah, people are waiting.
Bring your kids.
No, Adele feels pain. That's the problem.
Aye, Adele. You can do it. But you think me, I can't.
Yeah, I can do it, but it's going to be painful. So... that's kind of where
you know
I back away
within you. That you know.
Those are quotes for Instagram. However, guys,
I'll save that way.
We have Wendy Kimani in studio. Of course, we want to talk about the music. There's so much to talk about with her now that she's back in the 254. If you have any questions for her, send those our way on
way before Adele. Y'all were already singing to excess.
Unajua, and of course, it's playing right here on Kiss FM 23-9. And it's Gilad and Wendy Kimani. Wendy, who is live in studio with me, Adele Onyango and Shafi Weru. And this song dropped while you were not in Kenya, right?
No, I was not in Kenya. So I didn't even get the chance to enjoy performing it. But yeah, the few times I did, I went crazy.
You went home because you're like, this might be the last and first time.
We'll always, people loved it, so I think we'll always perform it.
When did, where were you? Do you remember the moment it hit you, how big it was? In Kenya?
I think when I came for Gilad Live, that's when it really hit me. We went to KU and we performed it. And, you know, when I started singing my part, I was like, wow. And I was just like, oh my God. What, can you almost forget the words?
Yes.
Yes. I was like, wait.
Okay.
But yeah, that was the best time.
And then there's Siende, which we're going to play in a bit. But tell me about music, because when you're that far away, we don't know, okay, has it stopped? Is it still going on? What exactly? Because I feel like we've grown with you from Project Fame days. What year was that?
Just babies.
What year was that?
That was 2008.
Wow.
2008. Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, going to Holland is not like an easy thing to just go in. You initially want to go and record there, but, you know, you can't get someone who really gets that African feel what we're doing. Everyone is like, there. So, which I don't mind, but, you know.
It wasn't your direction,
So, I mean, basically, I just chilled a bit because of the baby. You know, it takes time, and we don't have help there. So ni will and mtoto wako na mami, and that's it. So yeah, that's the thing. And but now he's bigger, you know.
Yeah,
he's ready to go to daycare.
Yeah,
so I was like, yeah, let me come back and start, you know,
seeing.
So where's the baby again?
The baby is drinking uji at home right now.
Oh, ako uku.
Sawa,
unakuja babysitting.
Unakuja, please,
yes.
Shafi.
I do babysittings on Sundays only. Yes.
On Sundays.
He's about to hit you with a big charge. I charge
per hour.
We're not in Holland.
So you think, okay, you think because you came here, everything is free?
Yeah.
The only thing free is free primary education. And imaginary laptops.
So have you been gigging there? Because I do follow you on Insta, and of course you started your YouTube. Do you do gigs? Are you performing? How's the reaction to you as a musician, that side?
I mean, guys are excited. The guys, the Kenyans who've been there for so long, Africans who've been there, they're excited. They're like, come perform this and that. I've been doing there's like a festival called Karibu Festival, and it's really done by three Dutch guys, but they do it so well. They play the most recent music.
Wow.
You know, you go to clubs there, and when it's Kenyan, they play old stuff. Kenyan, and it's
music,
like,
yes, dude, DJ's there.
Internet.
I'm not with it.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So these guys are amazing. I host with them. I sing with them.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, and I also sing in Amsterdam, a very well known place called Club Dauphine. So slowly.
Remember, Gilla told us that when he went to visit them.
Yeah.
Yes, they went for a function. Was it the Caribou one or where?
It was someone's birthday, actually.
Yes.
Like a really top
private thing. Know,
And so they're
really
like,
oh,
yes, we want her here. So we shot the video of Usiende. Literally dashed there.
Yes.
And performed. I was like 1 month pregnant. The exhaustion was like here. Oh my God.
But
these things are happening. So, you know, I like it. Yeah.
And what about, like, the culture shock? How was that for you?
I cannot even finish.
Yeah?
I cannot even finish, babe. This guy even, he's like, till today, he's just like, time.
Yeah.
Time. You have to keep time. Those guys, if you're supposed to be there at 8, that means you need to be there 7:55.
Yeah. That's why you guys were so early here
coffee.
Today.
Yeah.
Yes. Even for coffee.
Is she struggling with that?
Yeah, she is.
Babe.
No, but the thing is, here in Kenya, it's not a sign of disrespect to be late.
Yeah.
Back in Holland, Europe, especially Holland, Dutch people, German people, like, if you're late,
it's disrespect.
Disrespect.
Yeah, so they take it personally. Yeah.
I think
and then
it's
you
a
white thing. Can't even say niko kwa jam na kao.
No.
Yeah, I think it's a white people thing because.
Let me tell you, we got married in 2014.
Yeah.
Of course, we were late for our wedding.
Yeah.
So it goes in Kenya.
Yeah.
So my sister, she's like, we're late, I'm going to go to church. Why am I telling my sister? Like, but we're not there.
Yeah.
So what are you going to do there?
Yeah.
No. I just don't want to be late. So she just took a cab ride.
And went there. And waited for you guys.
And I was like, okay. Do you?
No, being late is Kenyan. Being late is Kenyan.
It's African.
Yeah, it's African. No, it's Kenyan, by the way. Us guys will take it to a whole new level.
And then we have traffic. So we're like, wow.
Now,
when you come back, it's a difficult thing. Mm-hmm. When you come back, it's
yeah, and it's haunting you.
You know, because I'm planning, I'm trying to plan things with producers. Okay, this is, so let me plan from Holland when I come. I am being told, Wendy's only if you can do it to town. I'm like, guy, what am I?
Okay. What is? So in the next few minutes, another thing that you've been very vocal about is how the two of you met. And everybody loves a brilliant love story. So we're definitely going to be getting into that.
Yes.
But speaking of love, the next 4 minutes, because of course we have Wendy Kimani live in studio with us and just loving her energy and of course her husband. Is also in studio with us. How did the two of you meet?
Do you want to tell the story?
Guest, huh?
Who's going to
We're
tell?
I'll give a short story.
Who has to tell the story? Who gets
but also,
to tell
like,
the story,
dudes leave out all the nyama from the story.
No.
They just like get to the point. We met.
No, but I'll give you the summary.
Okay,
so
it needs to be summarized.
Okay, so he sent me a message on MySpace.
Yeah,
the day.
MySpace.
Yeah. Exactly.
Peaceful high five.
Exactly. In a cyber. I mean, I'm in a cyber like this with my cousin.
Because I used to put your music. MySpace was really big for musicians.
It was big for music. So then I was like, who's this white guy? Netherlands? Like, who? What?
Yeah.
You know, and then, I was like, he's cute.
Yeah.
So we talked, you know, but we actually talked for 2 years as friends, you know.
Wow.
Light flirting.
You are pen pals, guys.
We are pen pals.
So you guys had never met?
We had never met for 2 years.
So online?
Online.
Just chatting.
Yeah. Chatting. After I told him
MySpace.
To video call me.
MySpace,
so that
remember?
Like
no, MySpace,
Exactly, yeah.
There was not Facebook, nothing.
No.
High five to
in a cyber.
Yeah.
So so then I had to go for an ISEC conference in Belgium.
Yeah.
I went there. It's like, Netherlands is right next door.
Yeah.
I trained 2 hours. I was like, I need to meet this guy.
He's
my best friend here. His address, everything, in case this guy decides to skin me alive.
Okay.
You can find my skin in Holland.
Yeah,
in this
and
address.
You'll know when it happens.
Yeah, so I went over and I met him. And it's like you've been talking for 2 years, but then you meet the first time.
Yeah.
It's weird, but then it just becomes normal because you know each other.
Yeah.
You know.
Okay.
You
That's
really
what I wanted to ask. Like the first time that you met her, were you like, oh my God,
what do I say? Yeah. Well, the thing is, our Dutch people are quite direct. So I was like, okay, when I meet her, I was scared of the friend zone happening.
Yeah.
So what I did, I saw her at the train station.
Yeah.
She was in front of me. So I just walked up to her and kissed her right on the mouth. Like, boom.
No, me and my African
list,
I'm standing there like, what is this guy doing in front of everybody here? Like, oh my God.
You've been talking for 2 years. Even me, I'd walk and kiss you right in the mouth. But only if you look the part.
Yes. Hey, she looked even better.
The issue with the blind dates again, yo, is, yo, so we've been chatting for 2 years, filters, ninini, and then I chomoka from the train station. Okay, up on the SGR station, I'm just there, perambulating, waiting, and then boom, she chomoka. And like, I can't missing.
He's like, no.
I thought nilikuwa na kaka mangumi.
Yeah.
So I was like, you know what? People have ugly friends, it's okay.
Yeah.
It's okay. So let me just say, sup.
Yeah.
You know.
you, what were your expectations?
I mean, I honestly had no expectation because you don't know. I mean, you know him so well that, and then when you meet, it's different.
Uh-huh. Yeah, because now it's, and there's all of this pressure also.
His eyes were so blue. His hair was so blonde.
Uh-huh.
I was just like, oh my God, this handsomeness. I can't deal with it.
So this is one of the cases of, you know
love
blind
online.
Dates that work. No, blind dates that work.
That work, it's true.
Forget about it being online.
But even the online bit for 2 years.
Yes.
I mean, that's something as well.
No, that's actually just online tech. Now dating, when you accept it, was 5 years.
Okay, so, but 2 years at least, you met him.
Yeah, after
and
2 years.
Whatever you met is what you expected and wanted.
Yes.
Because, you know, for other people.
Yeah. Yeah, but their personality can be completely different.
Yeah, because when you type, you have time to think.
Yes. Yeah, exactly.
Time to phrase it right. I mean, you can even have helpers. You know.
Yes.
But Adele does that for me every day.
Yeah,
and that's
Adele.
Why, until today, I don't have a girlfriend.
Okay, just stop with Adele then.
No.
Yeah, I'm quitting. I'm fired.
Helping you.
I have fired you.
Can I tell you, every time, Shafi goes against my warnings. He shows me a picture. I tell him, run. He still goes there.
That one works.
1 week later. Okay, I did something wrong. I'm just like, so I've given up, man. I've also quit. But
the 1,000th time is a charm.
Yeah. So what's with all of your experience, guys, what is like the one relationship advice you would leave Team Adele and Team Chaffee with? Like when it comes to relationships?
Long distance or in general?
Long distance.
And in general?
In general.
Yeah.
Don't give up with long distance.
Yeah.
It's very easy to give up and get caught up in your own personal situation.
Yeah.
But just don't give up.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you will have those days where you're just like, we haven't talked in 2 days. And then you kind of have that feeling of, you know,
yeah,
out of sight, out of mind sometimes. But then you always come back.
Yeah.
But also there's trying to be confused by other people, you know.
Yeah, the people who are already there.
Yeah.
You like, know, like the meet at hand.
Yeah, like this boyfriend you're always having. You meet a guy, they're like, yeah, no, me have a boyfriend. Like, every time you see him in the hanya, you never have this guy.
Where is this guy?
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's a ring.
Yeah.
There's a ring all the time. But now, if the person you have is...
Character-wise, the person,
you're just not looking for this cheap whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But it's also focus, right?
It's also focus.
Yes.
You know what you want. Yeah. He knew what he wanted. I knew what I wanted.
Yeah.
If I decided, maybe this wouldn't have worked. Or if he decided, it wouldn't have worked.
Yeah.
It's two people who know this is what we want.
You kind of have to like...
And visit each other as much as you can.
As much as you can.
As much
mm-hmm.
as you can.
Talk every day.
Also. I think people go into long distance thinking it's easy, but it's already a relationship is work.
It's your book,
this
your
is
book.
A bit more. Because you have to go the extra mile.
Yeah. Exactly.
Okay. So we're going to get back to the convo in the next 4 minutes. By the way, if you want to chime in, maybe... You're having the same situations as Shafi here. You want to
really,
ask
really.
Some love questions. You can... Your voice is so strong and so powerful. My God. At 3 minutes to nine, that's a song that followed up Unajua, you and Gilad Usi. And I feel like the two of you should just make a band at this point.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I think we'll always make music together.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
If we can.
Where did you meet Gilad?
So this is funny because actually I'm just gonna say this, on 2nd of June we're gonna have a Black Diamond reunion.
Okay,
we met at Black Diamond.
Black Diamond is still in existence.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, you're talking about the club, right?
Yes.
Not like the diamond itself. The club here
in
Red Light District.
Yeah. Yes, that's right.
Hold on, Kabla, don't get your club. Hi, Nia. Nia is listening. Oh, tell her hi.
Nia, that's his daughter.
Oh,
yes.
Hi, Nia. So
every time I'm driving her from school, she's always saying, I always say hi and I don't say hi back.
Oh.
So when she hears my voice, she goes like, hi, Dad, Baba. I'm like,
you're there busy.
No,
99,000. You're talking about your own thing.
So, hi, Nia. Enjoy school. We'll see you after ballet. Anyway, back to Black Diamond.
Oh God. I don't know why.
Guess what Nia's going to be asking you about when you pick her up. So what's Black Diamond?
Ngumi and Yangumi.
Anyway, so Black Diamond, that's how we met. Because I was singing with Calabash Band.
Yeah.
And Gilad was there. He always came, sang a few songs with them. You know. And we just talked. And it was so cool because he sang so well and started doing duets together. I was like, we kill it.
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. What was happening at Black Diamond? There was like a karaoke or those.
No,
like
band. Live band.
On Sundays, right?
Live band on Sundays.
Ah, okay.
I think it was one of my best days to perform because it's so late, you know. Black Diamond. It is. I mean, you can hear it anybody. But yeah, but then
I'm still shocked that Black Diamond is in existence.
Black
you know, you just come back. Are you sure? Have you been there?
Yeah, I'm telling you, on 2nd of June, we're going to have
come
a show.
Come and see with your eyes.
Black Diamond reunion.
Has it been opened on that day?
No, it's open. It's always open.
When did you come back?
On 4th
of May.
Yeah.
So have you been to Black Diamond?
Not yet.
But so I think it's still.
Just wait.
No, it's still.
Just come. It's there.
Anyway, those are Sturus for another day. But it's still.
just come and confirm.
I'll be there. No, on the 2nd, I'll be there. Yeah. But maybe I'm saying that's the day they're opening their doors again since.
No, they're open.
And then, let me continue this story.
Yeah.
So then, we actually wrote Unajua.
Mm-hmm.
We came up with Unajua there. And I remember telling
after how many?
Yeah, Gilad wanted me to just hum on Unajua.
This is June 2nd.
Yeah, June 2nd. 2008.
See now, June 2nd coming up.
No, I'm saying when you wrote the song, when you wrote the song.
Oh, that was like see now, okay.
Just after TPF.
No,
like
when did I go? 2014.
Uh-huh.
Okay,
yeah, that's when
so
we wrote the song.
So you wrote it on a Sunday night.
I wrote
after
it
your
Sunday night, we're over there just outside the balcony. I'm telling him, okay, you wanna hear the song? He's like, what song? You told me to write. Like, no. I said we were gonna do like harmonies. Like, well, I wrote.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nice.
Like, let me hear it. I sang it to him. I just saw those hamsters in his head just going like, oh my God.
I love
we
it.
Have
oh
something God. Here.
Yeah. And that's it. That's how Najwa came about. So we were like, we need to remember that.
What?
Because Gilad.
And you need to write another song up. On that balcony because clearly.
We have
that's
to.
No, that day
yeah.
we yeah. write
that's
another
place.
One.
That's the place. Yeah.
Exactly.
So people can come through. How much are tickets?
Tickets are 1,000 bob.
You get them at the gate?
Get them at the gate.
Okay.
And... yeah, it's gonna be an
at
amazing
Black
time.
D. Yani Black
yeah,
Diamond.
Black D.
Not Diamond Plaza.
Black D.
Equapa West D. Opposite former Resorras.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, those were good days.
Oh my Lord.
Those were good days.
Oh man.
Okay, so there's that, and then also in there's also your YouTube channel that you know you started. I think it started off with you talking about your hair.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's just like when you post a picture and people are like, oh my God, your hair.
Yeah.
I was like, yeah, I guess. Yeah. You know. But I just went natural. You know, I went natural because I was like, if I have to have a girl.
Yeah.
And then you're telling her, you know, now she'll be pointy.
Yeah.
And have the curly hair.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell her, don't straighten your hair. It's beautiful.
Yeah.
And that's a culture of straight hair.
Yeah.
And then me, I have my
yeah.
own one hair like this.
Yeah.
What am I going to tell her?
Yeah.
So I said, let me go natural. Plus, it was cheap to go natural.
Exactly.
It's affordable. Not cheap. Affordable.
Affordable.
Cheap is
affordable.
Bad.
Choice of words.
Cheap
yeah.
is bad.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Cheap is weave.
But then I went natural yeah. and it was like, I mean, as in I wear my hair the way it comes out of my head.
Yeah.
So people are like, please, I want to know, what are you using?
Yeah.
As in, how is it in the 3 years you
but
have
is,
that
is this, this is it because of the weather there?
No.
Because you know in Kenya. Hey,
no, but
you know,
Wendy has always had.
No.
You know, potholes kind of...
No, and then stress.
I love stress. You know, in Holland,
that?
You can be able to have natural hair because you know what? Everything is just like, you know, everything is systematic and quirky.
No, it's not.
Yeah? And even the air there is different.
So it's about
so don't lie to Kenyan chicks, yeah.
Wait,
it's simple.
What else do you talk about?
I talk about my hair, but I'm going to talk about being there, you know?
I think that would be cool.
In the diaspora,
yeah.
Because people really want to know.
And people lie to us about how easy it is.
I'm being asked
for money. For money by your relatives.
So, I mean, no, but I'm not going to talk about that. But what I'm going to talk about
no, you should.
You know, the culture shock, like what you asked me.
Yeah.
I think guys will
find it interesting. There's a lot of culture
shock. And also the chicks who hit you up on your DM trying to get you to hook them up with a white man.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm sure.
I'll just have a notice board outside. I'll have a notice board outside. I'll be reaching out. I see a kawaii guy who's like, you look single.
Are you looking for some melanin?
Nice melanin.
Black girl magic.
Black, deep, nice. Good
however,
wife.
Okay, so we need to move on. Thank you so much, guys, for coming through and hanging out with us. You guys have such good energy. And of course, guys, June 2nd, Black Diamond Reunion. Gilad, Wendy on stage. Once again, it's been a while. 1,000 bob at the gate. Make sure you're there for that. It starts at what time?
It starts at 8.